anything.
Hi, folks.
Disconnected.
It's good to be with you today. We're sharing the gospel today in the book of Isaiah. Isaiah 53 says, "Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray, we have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all." And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. What that means is that Christ came to be a Savior. He came to die for you on that cross. And that if you want to be reconciled to God, if you want to know that you're not going to go to hell and you want to go to heaven, is to know that you cannot earn your way to heaven. You cannot get your way to heaven. The only way that you can get to heaven is by believing that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. And that's why he came. And when he came as a Savior. He had a purpose and he had a plan to come and die on that cross for you. And if you want to be reconciled to God, if you want to know God as your friend, you've got to understand that there's only one way to heaven. There's only one way to know God. There are many cults out there pumping their false teaching. There are many false religions out there pumping their false teaching. But Jesus Christ is the only way that we can get saved. He is the only one that can save us. He is the only one that can save us from the judgment and the wrath to come. One day you will die. One day I will die. And when you die, that's not the end. When you die, that's not the end. When you die, then there is the judgment. We come before the judgment seat of Christ. And when we come before the judgment seat of Christ, we have to be ready for that judgment day. And how do we face the judgment seat of Christ?
How do we face that judgment?
Well, some say by your own efforts, by what you do. Some say by religion.
Some say by philosophy. Some say science. But we say that Christ died and rose again. He said, "I am the resurrection and the life." That he conquered death.
And because he conquered death, and because he died for you and for me, because he died for you and because he died for me, because he died for you and because he died for me,
because he died for you
and because he died for me, if you believe on him, whoever you are, you can be saved.
If you believe on Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior,
if you believe in him as your Lord and Savior, you can be saved. You cannot be saved by what you do. You cannot be saved by what you do. Whatever you do will not get you into heaven, but he will get you into heaven. He will save you. He will get you into heaven. Because he is the one that took your punishment. He is the one that took your wrath. He is the one that died in your place. When he was nailed to that cross and the crown of thorns was on his head, and he was nailed to that cross, he was taking the wrath and the punishment for you on that cross. He was dying and taking the wrath that you and I deserve. And so we have to acknowledge in our lives sin. Sin is rebellion against the word of God. You shall not lie, you shall not steal, you shall not commit adultery, you shall honor your father and mother, you shall have no other gods before me, you shall not use the Lord's name in vain. This is sin. And we break that sin and we come under God's judgment. But Christ died in your place. He died in your place to save you. He laid down his life to save you. But you've got to flee to the cross. You've got to flee to Jesus. You've got to flee to the Lord and ask him for forgiveness. And ask him for mercy. And if you come to the cross, and if you come to Jesus, you will be covered in the blood of the Lamb. You will be cleansed. You will be washed. You will become a new person. It says that there is no condemnation to them that are in Christ.
And there will be no condemnation. There will be no judgment.
There will be no judgment because you fled to the blood of Jesus. But you have to flee to the blood of the Lamb. You have to flee to the blood of the Lamb. You have to go to the blood. The blood was shed for you on that cross. He laid down his life. One day you're going to die. One day you'll die.
And when you die, where will you go?
When you die, where will you go? There is a heaven and a hell.
And you need to know where you're going to go.
And it's knowing Jesus. It's knowing Christ as your Savior. It's trusting in him and only in him. That is how you know you can get to heaven, by trusting him. Jesus says, come to me, all you who are weak and heavy laden, that I will give you rest.
Drugs will not give us rest.
Violence will not give us rest. We seek rest and hope in things that are not helpful. But Jesus Christ will give us rest. Not getting drunk. Not swearing like a gangster rapper. But Jesus Christ, he will give us rest. He will give us rest. You don't need to swear like a gangster rapper anymore. You don't need to smoke wacky backy anymore.
What are you smoking wacky backy for?
You don't need to. You don't need to smoke wacky backy. You don't need wacky backy.
Did you drop the knife for you?
Did you drop the knife for you?
We're insulting God.
Did you pass the knife for you?
Because if we repent,
he died for you on the cross.
He shed his blood.
He says if we do repent,
he laid down his life for you on that cross.
He shed his blood for you on that cross.
I already did it at the cross.
And died on that cross for you. That you may live. That you may live. And know his peace. And know his love is
clear. Thank you for your grace. You know, that's the impression I got.
I love that if you're talking with me.
He died for you on that cross. And he shed his blood for you on that cross.
He died for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life for you.
And he says to you today, if you trust him as your Lord and Savior,
you'll be saved. But if you reject him, the Lord warns of a hell. He warns of judgment.
He warns of a hell. He says there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
He warns of the wrath to come. He warns of hell. He warns of judgment. But when he died on that cross, he took your judgment.
When he died on that cross, he took your punishment.
And he gave everything that he could. He laid down his life. All that he had was punished, was battered through. And when he went on that cross and the nails were in his hands, and as he had a crown of thorns on his head, and as he was on that cross and the blood was coming down, he was dying on that cross for you. He was dying on that cross for you. And the Lord is encouraging you to come to him.
The Lord is encouraging you to come to him. The Lord is encouraging you to come to him. To have faith in him,
to believe in him, to trust in him, to look to him, to know his love, to know his grace, to know his mercy, to know his blessings,
to know his peace, to know his joy, to know his grace. That's what he wants for you in your life.
All you have to do is believe in him, and trust in him, and look to him as your Lord and Savior. But you've got to repent. You've got to turn away from the things that are not good in your life. You've got to feel sorry for the things that you've done wrong, and turn to Christ who died on that cross for you.
And if you turn to Christ, and if you look to him, he will forgive you. He will cleanse you. He will
restore you, he will show you his mercy. But you have to trust him.
You have to lean upon him.
Some of you are ducking and diving like Alphadele or Delboy. Some of you are doing things you know you shouldn't be doing.
We all make mistakes, we all fail, we all let God down.
But at the end, we have to come to the cross. And not at that cross, he laid down his life. Not at that cross that he shed his blood. Not at that cross that he died on your behalf. Not at that cross that he gave his life. Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Behold the Lamb of God that was shed for you. Behold the Lamb of God that died for you. He died on that cross and shed his blood for you on that cross. One day you die. One day you will die. And when you die, you will meet your maker. And when you meet your maker, the question is, where did you stand? What did you stand on? When you die, you'll meet your maker. You can meet him in hell or you can meet him in heaven. What you do with Jesus Christ will determine where you end up. If you believe in him, trust him, and follow him, you'll end up in heaven. If you reject him and ignore him and trample him underfoot, then you'll end up in hell. I don't want you to go there. God doesn't want you to go there. But God offers you the grace. He offers you his mercy. He offers you his salvation. And he commands everyone, everywhere to repent. Me and everybody else, we have to repent. We have to repent. And turn away from that which is wrong. Turn away from lies. Turn away from anything that's not right. We have to turn away. And trust in Christ and look to Christ as our salvation. Look to Christ as our Lord. And look to him as our Savior. That is our only hope today. Religion cannot save you. Religion is man's ideas, man's works. Religion cannot help. Religion causes war. It's a personal relationship with Jesus. That's what makes the difference. Having that personal relationship with Jesus. Knowing him as your Lord. Knowing him as your Savior. Being born again of the Holy Spirit, being born again of God, being born again of Jesus, knowing the Holy Spirit in your life, breathing in the Holy Spirit, not breathing in wacky backy, breathing in the Holy Spirit of God, not breathing in wacky backy, but breathing in the Spirit of God, breathing in God. You don't need to smoke wacky backy. You don't need to fiddle the gas bill. You don't need to fiddle the electric bill. You don't need to duck and dive and fiddle the gas bill or fiddle the electric bill. You don't need to be smoking wacky backy. You don't need to be swearing like a gangster rapper. Some of you swear at home, you swear in front of your kids. You don't need to be swearing like a gangster rapper. Some of you swear in front of your grandma and your granddad. No! You don't need to be doing that. He died for you on that cross. He shed his blood for you on that cross. He gave his life for you on that cross. He died to save you, to renew you, to bring you home to heaven. He died to bring you home. So come home. Come home to your Father. Come home to your Savior. Come home to him who shed his blood. Come home to him who died for you. Come home to him who loved you. Come home to him. Say, Lord, I'm coming. I'm leaving my wacky backy. I'm not going to be swearing like a gangster rapper. I'm not going to be fiddling the gas bill or the electric bill. I'm coming home. I'm coming to you, God, because you died for me. I'm coming to you, Jesus, because you gave you your life for me. I'm coming home because I know that you love me and you died for me. And I'm coming to you, Jesus. So come home. Leave the old life behind. Leave the old life. You don't need the old life anymore. Leave it behind and step into the new life of Jesus. Step into the new life of him. Step into the new life. The resurrection life, the kingdom life, the life of being born again. Step into that by faith. move from being a caterpillar to being a butterfly. Change, and you can change and be transformed by being born again today. God wants to come in and change you. God wants to come in and bless you. God wants to guide you. He wants to show you His way. And it begins by finding the cross, by knowing at the cross that He laid down His life. And if you were to die tonight, if you were to die tonight, you will know where you're going if you trust Him. If you believe Him, you will know that you're going to go to heaven if you trust Him. If you die tonight and believe Jesus, you will go to heaven. Knowing Jesus, knowing the Lord, knowing Him is our only hope.
My friends, hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of Jesus.
Hear the word of God. There is hope and salvation in Jesus. Hear the word of the Lord today. And know His peace, and know His love, and know His joy today. Know that He'll save you, know that He'll give you peace.
Know that He'll give you joy.
There is power, power for the working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power for the working power in the blood of the Lamb.
There is joy, joy on the working plan in the heart of the land.
There is joy,
joy on the working plan in the heart of the land.
There is peace, peace on the working peace in the heart of the land. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine,